Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let me show you how to manage your iOS device backups on your Mac. So if you have your iOS device set to backup to your computer, which you probably should, then every time you sync it to your Mac, it will create a backup there and it will replace the previous backup. But you could still end up with extra backups, especially if you move from old devices to new devices or you completely restore a device. You end up with the old backup and also your new one. So every once in a while it could be a good idea to look and see what backups you have stored in iTunes. And doing so is easy if you know where to look. So here I am in iTunes 11 and you may be tempted to turn on the sidebar and try to look for devices on the left and control click on them and things like that. And that's not where you find the backups. Where you find the backups is in iTunes preferences. And under preferences there's a tab here for devices. And under devices you'll see a list of iTunes backups. And right away I can see I have an issue here because I've got some old things. I've got my old iPhone 3G at some point was backed up to this account and I have a backup from last year in March. So that's probably something I don't need anymore. And you can see how I can select it and I can hit delete backup and it will ask me to confirm and I can remove that backup from the drive. So this is a way to clean up those old ones. It's also a good way to check to make sure that you have a recent backup. So you can look, for instance, on my iPad 2, which is pretty recent. I've got a recent backup and that's good. It's kind of good to get the confirmation of the time of that backup. Now, what else can I do here? Well, I can select one of these and I can control click on it and get some additional options. There's the delete option, the same as using this button. But I also have show in Finder. And this will bring up a Finder window and it'll show me exactly where the backup is. So for instance, here I can check to see that these backups are in library, application support, mobile sync, backup, and then there's these really cryptic folder names. I'd never be able to tell which was which without using this functionality here to know that I was going to it. That's the old 3G iPhone. If I use the iPhone 4S and I say show in Finder, it brings up a new Finder window and I could see this one here is one for that. And in the Finder I could select that and do Command I and I could see that that's 4.3 gigs. So I probably do want to get rid of that if I'm no longer using that device. I've moved on from it. So it's best not to delete from the Finder here. To do everything nice and cleanly, use iTunes. Since this backup was created by iTunes, use iTunes to delete it. Here using the delete backup button instead of deleting in the Finder. Now another function that you've got here is to archive. So in this one here let's do archive. So what does that archive function do? Well, what it does is it basically closes this backup. So it puts a date on it, today's date, the one I'm recording this video on. And if I were to back up that same device again it would create a new backup. So this could be important, for instance, if you're going to make some major changes. Maybe you're a developer and you're going to change something with your device and you want to save that backup and not have it get replaced the next time you back up. So if I were to archive this old 3G again, it would create a new one called old 3G and this one would remain there as long as I kept it. I could control and delete right there or use the delete backup to get rid of it once I'm sure that I've moved on. So archiving's something a typical user wouldn't need to use, but deleting an old backup could be, especially if you've gone through several iOS devices and want to clear off some space on your drive. Just make sure you don't delete your most recent backup. Of course, if you do, all you need to do is plug your device in and back it up right afterwards and you are backed up again. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it'll just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.